Here's a quick, easy recipe for deer tenderloins. We have done this for years, and it's the easiest recipe in the world to make, and I'm surprised more people don't do this. But you just take plain old barbecue sauce, take your tenderloin, coat it in the bottom, and then just coat the top of it. And I try to basically use the whole bottle. You can't use too much. Just coat it. You got two layers of tin foil here. One and two. And you're just going to basically take it and you're going to fold it into a pocket. So the top one, really all the top one does is that right there. And then fold your corners in. Okay. So what you're trying to do here is just kind of create like a little pocket so that all of the barbecue sauce doesn't come out. And then the top one is to seal it. So just carry that over. And then you're going to seal it up on both sides. You don't have to be real particular about it. Voila. It's okay if it vents a little bit. And stick it in a pan like that. It is literally that simple. So we've got our deer tenderloin covered in barbecue sauce, wrapped in two layers of tinfoil, stuck on a pan. Oven at 275. We're going to cook these for about 3.5 hours. 3.5 to 4 hours. We've got it on the middle rack here. Close it up. 3 to 4 hours. It's delicious. All right, so we've cooked our deer tenderloin. Just pulled it out of the oven. You can see that some of the juices will come through, which is why I always recommend you put it on a pan. When you open it up, it's not going to look what I would call very appetizing. But this is essentially what it looks like. It's full of all the juices from the barbecue sauce, which is why I use it that way. These inner tenderloins have definitely shrunk a little bit. But the reason why I do this is because of all this juice in here. It makes it really moist. You pull it out. We're going to cut it on the cutting board. Just going to kind of chop it up with the knife. I'm not going to show you how to do that because that's boring. Then I'm going to show you the three different ways that you can prepare it after it's chopped up. Okay, so what you can see we've done here is just basically chop it up. It's not rocket science. You just take a big knife, chop it up, and I've split it up in three different sections just so you show you what we do. So this section is what we call dry. There's no extra sauce. A lot of people like it that way because of this coating right here. And that coating is the barbecue sauce is kind of baked into it. And, you know, you can put it on a hamburger bun, you can put it on bread, you can eat it plain like on a pork plate. And a lot of people really prefer it that way. You can add salt to it if you want or any other seasoning, but that's just straight up plain. This way, what we do is we take our barbecue sauce and you just dump it on there. Like I said, with this whole process, it's meant to be easy. It's not supposed to be difficult. It's not supposed to be rocket science. We call this wet. You just kind of mix it in there. You probably add a little bit more barbecue sauce to this, but for the purpose of this video, you kind of get the point. This is really, really good, I think, on a hamburger bun or something like that. But that right there, that's wet. And then this way is kind of our dry rub. We use butt rub, just what I've used for years and years. We just take it and we kind of generously put it on there. And you can see there's a whole bunch on there. And that stuff definitely is spicy. And we just kind of mix it up. And just kind of keep it dry like that. You can add a little bit of barbecue sauce to it, but don't put a lot on here because then it just gets way too seasoned and you can't even taste the meat. So this is a favorite of our families that we've done for years. We've probably used butt rub for the last, I don't know, decade or plus. So it's kind of spicy. You can still taste the meat. That's if you like it wet, and that's just straight up plain. So it's an easy way to cook deer. It's a very, very simple way to cook a tenderloin so that it doesn't taste gamey and it's easy to prepare and you can please the masses. So there's your three choices. Let us know what you think. We appreciate you watching.